Here with the video. It's been a little while, but I've been busy here on the farm and taking care of my newborn son Holden. So but I wanted to talk to you today about the U.S. Coast Guard in the Vietnam War. Some of you are probably saying, the Coast Guard served in Vietnam? Aren't those guys just the ones that go out and, you know, rescue people? And you'd be right. Typically most people, when they think of the Coast Guard, think of guys wearing stuff like this rather than what I'm wearing, which is kind of representative of what a Coast Guardsman in Vietnam would have worn. But, you know, the Coast Guard was formed out of the U.S. Revenue Cutter Service and the U.S. Life Saving Service. And, you know, their primary role was and still is, you know, patrolling the coasts of the United States and enforcing maritime law and search and rescue operations. But the skill to operate those smaller watercraft in austere conditions has had them be called upon in, during America's overseas conflicts, where that skill of operating a small boat is needed. So during World War II, a lot of Coast Guardsmen operated the landing craft for amphibious operations such as D-Day and throughout the whole Pacific campaign. And one Coast Guardsman in World War II was awarded the Medal of Honor for his actions while operating a landing craft. And that's a subject for another video. But once again, during Vietnam, the Defense Department saw a use for the Coast Guardsmen and their small boats in inside Vietnam. And they would be called upon to serve between 1965 and 1970. And they were part of what was called United States Coast Guard Squadron 1. There was Squadron 1 and Squadron 3, and they had different divisions throughout the country. This is a Division 12 Squadron 1 patch. So what they were doing was patrolling the coasts of Vietnam and trying to stop supplies coming in to South Vietnam from North Vietnam via the water. Vietnam has a very long coastline and has a lot of small waterways, rivers, and that North Vietnamese and Viet Cong were using that to move supplies south, in addition to the Ho Chi Minh Trail, which was all the footpaths and small trails and roads that came from North Vietnam through Laos, Cambodia, into South Vietnam. So these guys were interdicting small boats, doing small boat searches, and they were even providing, fire support for ground units that were operating close to the shoreline with their boats. So they were operating 82-foot patrol boats, and they were equipped with machine guns and 81-millimeter mortars, and those were of the point-class cutters. So there'll be pictures, before in the after part of this video of those different boats. So, like I said, they served from 65 to 70, started to train the South Vietnamese Navy to take over what they were doing and slowly transition equipment over. But prior to that, they were patrolling all of the coasts between, the DMZ down. And in addition to, like I said, their patrol operations and fire support operations, they did do a lot of humanitarian operations in South Vietnam as well. And so that was their scope of what they did. Like I said, equipment-wise, they were using the point glass cutters. They had kind of a unique weapon system on the front of that boat. They had taken off the 20-millimeter cannons and replaced it with a M2 50-cal machine gun with an 81-millimeter mortar. They were, like, mounted together. And, like I said, there'll be pictures of that. Kind of a unique weapon system. And as was tradition with the Coast Guard, even to this day, they always get the hand-me-downs, and they always scrounging for supplies because they have such a small budget. When these guys first arrived in Vietnam, they had no supplies other than their boats, and their standing order was anytime they went out to bum supplies off the Navy, they had to basically go find a Navy ship or a merchant marine ship and get supplies, because initially they didn't have anything. And if you talk to my buddy Jeff, I'm sure he'll still tell you today the Coast Guard sometimes struggles with having what they need. They're the smallest force in the U.S. military. There's only about 30,000 or so people in the U.S. Coast Guard, which may seem like a lot, but if you compare that to the other branches of service, it's very small. So uniforms, you'll see them wearing the M55 flak vest, like what I'm wearing. This was issued to Marines primarily, but you know, Navy and Coast Guard personnel also wore it. You'll see them wearing the standard M1 helmet, typically with no covers on, and they'll also have the Navy Mark II Talker helmet. I don't have an example of one of those, but it's a big, goofy-looking helmet that was meant to wear a radio headset underneath so they could communicate. And usually the guy operating the 50 cal, 81-millimeter mortar combo is wearing that, and the loader is... or the assistant gunner is wearing the standard helmet. So, otherwise, they wore standard Navy uniforms. You'll either see them wearing summer whites. Sometimes they're just wearing a white t-shirt. And other times, you'll see them wearing the blue dungarees uniform. So, they fall under the U.S. Navy during the Vietnam War, so their equipment's pretty much the same stuff. And that still continues to a certain extent to this day. The Coast Guard gets a lot of Navy hand-me-downs. So today, the U.S. Coast Guard does continue to do overseas service. They have through the whole War on Terror. They do patrol overseas with U.S. Navy ships. They are doing that right now with their larger cutters. They augment the Navy's fleet when needed. And the U.S. Coast Guard just doesn't get a lot of recognition, and I wanted to shed some light on that. Their service in the Vietnam War as part of my series of videos I'm doing on Vietnam. And they just, like I said, they don't get a lot of service or recognition for their service. You know, one account I saw in a documentary on their service in Vietnam, a gentleman was talking about how he had just arrived back and the police chief in his town was over at his house, or they were at an event together. And he said his son-in-law was coming back from Vietnam in the Army. And he mentioned, well, I just got back. And the police chief said, yeah, but you were just in the Coast Guard. So people don't recognize them for what they do. Even in a non-combat environment, you have to be pretty brave to do some of what the Coast Guard does. And I think they deserve that recognition. So I'm sure I'll have some other videos with the Coast Guard you know, in mind coming up, but that's pretty much all I have for now. If you want to learn more on the U.S. Coast Guard's operations in Vietnam, there are a few documentaries on YouTube you can check out, and I'll see what else I can dig up. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll be back with more videos soon.
People forget that we went through some of the same agony a lot of the other service people did as well. The chief of police in my town came to the house to go out to dinner with my parents. His son-in-law was coming back from Vietnam in the Army. And I said, I just got back. And he said, yeah, but you were just in the Coast Guard. And that's the kind of thing that we've had.